Chapter number one, ideological basis of Pakistan. Your syllabus. Chapter number one, ideological basis of Pakistan. My dear students, before starting the lesson, I would like to share the meaning of the ideology. What does the means of ideology? Ideology means ideas about the life according to the culture, according to the religious, according to the social boundaries. Logy means studies, discussion. When we merge these two things, it's become the branch of the social sciences, which means the study of the ideas, the study of the idea. So the word ideology is French in origin, and it has the two components, namely the idea and the logy. It means the systematic body of the concept about the life of the culture. And the second definition of the ideology is the sets of the belief, ideas, and the values which direct the one's goals. What does mean? It means that. Here I would like to share the examples of the Pakistan. Now, keep the Pakistan movement in their mind, 1857 to the 1947. My dear students, Pakistan is not the thought of a single man. It's the thought and the idea of the billions of the Muslims of the subcontinent. Now, when the billions of the Muslims sit together and thought about their condition of the subcontinent, they have decided there should be a separate state for the Muslims of the South Asia. This is called the Pakistan, and Pakistan is the perfect picture of the ideology. My dear student, I am going to repeat the definition of the ideology. Ideology is the sets of belief, ideas, and the values which direct one's goals. And you can take the help from page number 5 of your textbook. The word ideology is French in origin. It makes up of two components, namely the idea and the logy. Ideology is the systematic body of the concept, especially about the life of the culture. Okay, now, my dear student, we are the citizen of Pakistan. Be proud to be the citizen of Pakistan. Pakistan is an Islamic state. Before going in the depth of the ideology of the Pakistan, I would like to share the kinds of the ideology. There are the three kinds of the ideology: religious ideology, political ideology, and economical ideology. Now, listen the name of the Pakistan. The complete name of the Pakistan is the Islamic Republic of Pakistan. It is Islam. Republic is the democracy, and Pakistan is the state. Means two words, the Islam, Republic, and Pakistan. Islam is the identification of the religious ideology. Democracy means freedom, is the reflection of the political ideology. And being a citizen of Pakistan, we have the freedom to live and earn their bread for life. Okay, so Islamic Republic of Pakistan is the complete name of Pakistan. It indicates the three types of the ideology. The word ideology is French in origin. Okay, ideology. Ideology means ideas. Logy means studies. Then we merge these two words, it's become the science of the ideas. Now, we are the Muslim. Being a Muslim, we know Pakistan. We get the Pakistan in the name of the Islam, and Pakistan is the fort of the Islam. Pakistan is the fort of the Islam. Okay, my dear student, Pakistan is a part of the Islam, and now we are the part of the Islamic society. Here I would like to share the foundation of the Islamic society. In 622, when the Holy Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam migrated to Medina and set up an Islamic society. Okay, this is called the Hijra, first Hijra. Okay, 622 AD, first Hijra. The Islamic society which founded by the Holy Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, which based on the three principles. Number one, all powers belong to Almighty Allah. Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is the last prophet, and all the Muslims are brother among themselves. So, Islam is the second most popular religion of the world. Islam is the second most popular religion of the world. Islam is a religion of peace. Islam is a religion of love. Islam, the teaching of Islam always emphasizes on the humanity. Humanity means respect the humans in account of the justice, in account of the tolerance, in account of the brotherhood, and in account of the fraternity. My dear students, Pakistan's ideology based on Islamic ideology based on the three things, sources of Islamic ideology. What are the sources of Islamic ideology? As I have told you, we are the part of the Islamic society, being a Pakistani, we are the part of the Islamic society, and the Islamic ideology based on the three components. Number one, the Holy Quran. The Holy Quran, Sunnah, tradition, and cultural values. The Holy Quran, being a Muslim, we daily recite the Holy Quran, but we do not understand it. What are the teaching of the Holy Quran says? The Holy Quran is the permanent basis of Islam. 30 paras. Have mentioned all the problems, have mentioned all the in Quran mention all the problems of the life being a Muslim. If you thoroughly read the Quran and act upon it according to the teaching of the Holy Quran, you will never go wrong, inshallah. Now, Sunnah. What is the meaning of the Sunnah? Sunnah means our Holy Prophet, Khatam al-Mursaleen, Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Sunnah, the acts and the deed of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When we follow the deeds of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the action of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it's become the Sunnah. Sunnah is an Arabic term. The meaning of the Sunnah is the way to follow. It means the ways which told us by the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. If we act according to the teaching of the sallallahu alaihi wasallam, so we are following the Sunnah. Tradition and cultural values. Okay, my dear student, what is the difference between the tradition and the cultural values? Now, our daily routine, morning till night, and our social gathering, the festivals, the ceremonies, there is a quite difference between them. But when we have the same social values, means our social gathering have the same pattern. So tradition and the cultural values will be same. Being a Muslim, we know when we marriages, when we attend the death ceremonies of the people. So it's totally a reflection of the tradition and the cultural values. Now the perfect picture of the tradition and the cultural values we see at the time of the Hajj every year. People, they belong to the different races, they belong to the different countries, they belong to the different communities, but when we have the one platform, they have the same words, they have the same dress, it means that our tradition and our cultural values are same. I hope that the student, all of you have understood about the definition of the ideology, the meaning of the ideology, and the sources of the Islamic ideology. Now, why we learn ideology and the significance of ideology. As I have given you the examples of the Pakistan, when the Pakistan movement started, it was not the cause, it was not the voice of the single Muslims of the subcontinent. It becomes the voice of the billions of the Muslims of the subcontinent, that the first significance of the ideology. It reflects the ideas of the people and determines the way thinking and the social interaction. Now, when the problems become the over and over in the South Asia, people determine their way, they have the separate homeland. Okay? Now, when they raise the voice for the separate homeland, they unite on a one platform. One platform means they have the one voice. What one voice? There should be a separate homeland for the Muslims of the South Asia. It will be the Pakistan. It is a motivating force. What does it mean that the motivating force? It means to motivate the people. Now, those people, they understand the philosophy. They understand the philosophy. They understand the teaching. Now, they can easily motivate the other people because by their deeds and by their action. During the Pakistan movement, people were not the educated, especially the women. Now, the men and the women work together and they motivate the people to please join the Pakistan movement for the voice, for the one voice of the South Asia subcontinent, Pakistan. What are the significance of the ideology of Pakistan? It is a source of struggle. It is a source of struggle for achieving the divine, for achieving the divine's objectives. Objective serves as a motivational force of progress and the prosperity under a recognized and the truthful leadership. Prosperity. What does it mean of the prosperity? Prosperity means a strong state. Now, today, Pakistan is the strongest state of the world. Ideology provides an insight in making the choice of the leader, helps in making the right decision. Yes, this is the very most important, and it reflects the political ideology. You are the part of the Pakistan, means you are the Pakistani citizens. You have the right to select the right people for the state. Means you have an opportunity to choose the correct people for the government. Now, next, it's helped to preserve the freedom, culture, and tradition. Ideological nation face no problem in the legislation because basic principle exist uniform of the ideology. Ideology plays vital role in the national identity. It discriminate a nation from the other. It means that there is no differences on the basis of the caste. Community, okay. Now, being a citizen, we are all the same rights and the same duties. Now, next topic is the contents of ideology. Now, what is the difference between the sources and the content? We have discussed the sources of the Islamic ideology. Now we are going to share the contents of the ideology. The contents of the ideology are four. Number one, common religion. Number two, common culture. Number three, common cause. Number four, dedication. Common religion. Common religion means being a Muslim, we have the one religion. As I have told you, the Islam is the second most popular religion of the world. The first popular religion of the world is the Christianity. Okay? Now, the religion is a binding force for the nation of the world. Nations in the world are distinctive on the basis of the religion. Means in the world there are the different religions, you know, the Christianity, Muslims, Buddhism, Jews, okay. So it reflects the the ideology. Now the common culture, what does the meaning of the common culture? Generally the people sharing a common culture follow the similar way of life. Normally they do not compromise on their custom and the tradition. Culture means, being a Pakistani, we have the four culture: the Sindhi culture, the Punjabi culture, the Balochi culture, and the Pashtun culture, as well as the Kashmiri culture. When we merge all these cultures, the domestic or the regional culture, we have the one culture, which is called the Pakistan's culture. Okay. Now, common causes. What does the meaning of the cause? Cause means we have aims and objectives. According to the aims and objectives, we spend our lives. A common cause unites the people in the achievement of the Pakistan was a common cause. I have already shared with you. Thoughts were the different. People were the different. But the cause was the same. Means Pakistan. Dedication. What are the means of the dedication? What are the means of the dedication? Dedication means what we have. Means if we have the property, if we have the strength. The strength is energy. What can we do for the society? Okay, we dedicate our lives. We reserve our each and everything for the society, for the nation, for the country. It will become the dedication. Now, my dear student, Pakistan's ideology, the basis of the Pakistan's ideology has the two components. One is the doctrine of the faith. When we recite the first kalima, La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah, it means that we have the very strong belief that Wahdahu la Sharik, there is no power except Allah. There is no except Allah. Allah is the Almighty of the universe. Now, we have the strong belief on the revised book of Almighty Allah. There are four revealed books. We have the four revealed books: Torah, Injil, Zabur, and Quran Majid. And the Quran Majid reveals on our Holy Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam in the period of, you know very well, then me. The Quran is the last holy book revealed to the Holy Prophet bit by bit. Now, doctrine of the faith. Now, doctrine of the faith, the first is all power belongs to Almighty Allah. Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is last prophet and Quran is the last holy book of Allah. And we have the belief, a strong belief on the day of the judgment. We call it the Yawme Akhirat. We have the very strong belief. What we are doing in the world, what we are doing in our society, what we are doing in the society, what we have, then we will reward in the last day of the Yawme Akhirat. We call it the Yawme Akhirat. Okay. So ideology of the Pakistan is to mold over the individual and the collective lines according to the teaching of the Islam and the safeguard ourselves against those ideologies that are against the Islam. Now, that the social dealings. What are the means of the social dealings? Social dealings means interaction. Dealing means the interaction. When we meet the upper class people, when we meet the lower class people, when we meet the middle class people. Okay? So, in the eyes of the Islam and the Islamic, according to the Islamic teaching and the Islamic point of view, there is no discrimination on the basis of the caste, on the basis of the culture, on the basis of the social religious values. My dear students, to keep in your mind, it is a very important point. Now today we are facing the problems. Okay, so keep in your mind about the social distance and the social dealings. Okay, so you can save yourself. Now, what I have discussed with you, the basis of the Pakistan ideology. The basis of Pakistan's ideology totally depends on the two things two things. It means that doctrine of the faith means we have the belief on the kalma-e-tawheed. Means, what does the means of the first kalma? Kalma-e-paak, la ilaha illallah, Muhammadur Rasulullah. It means doctrine of the faith. We have the very strong belief on that. There is only one God who is the creator of the universe, Almighty Allah. Okay, all power belongs to Almighty Allah. Now, my dear student, I would like to repeat from the first point till the last point. Those students joined me late. Okay, now the further topic or the further subtopic we will inshallah continue tomorrow and the next day. We have 3 days classes. Okay, so now today task I have already covered. Okay, now I would like to revise that. First, the definition and the meaning of the ideology. Second, the sources of the Islamic ideology. Third, the contents, significance of the ideology. Then the content of ideology and the basis of ideology of Pakistan. Okay, before sharing the home task, I would like to review these subtopics. Okay, from the page number 5, you can easily understand the definition, the meaning, and the definition of the ideology. Okay, the meaning and the definition of the ideology. The word ideology is French in origin, and it means it's made up of two components, namely the idea and the logy. Ideology, the systematic body of the concept, especially about life or culture. Okay, now, then we have already discussed the Islamic society, which based on the 3 principles, all powers belongs to Almighty Allah, Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is last prophet, and all the Muslims are brother among themselves. Now, sources of the Islamic ideology, there are the 3 sources of the Islamic ideology, the Holy Quran, the Sunnah, and the tradition and the cultural values. Now, the significance of ideology, it unites the people on a one platform. It is the motivating force. It reflects the ideas of the peoples. They belong to the different culture, different causes, different religions. It is the source of their struggle for achieving the one goal. Provides an insight making the choice of the leadership. Okay, and now it has preserved the freedom, culture, and the tradition. Now, the contents of the ideology, there are the 4 contents of the ideology: common religion, common culture, common cause, and the dedication. Okay, and the Pakistan's ideology, I have already shared with you the Pakistan's ideology based on 2 things. Doctrine of faith. Doctrine means belief of faith. Faith is called the Iman. Okay, I have recited the first kalma, La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. It means that we have the very strong belief that Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala is only the one of the creator of the universe, and Muhammad is his last prophet. And the social dealing, I have already shared with you the social dealing. When the people belongs to the upper class, the lower class, the middle class, the rich, the white, the black, the short and the long, the wealthy or the poor, we should mingle with each other to resolve the problems of the society and the nation. Okay, now, my dear students, note down the homework. You will write the answer, short answer and question. Okay, keep pencil and notebook in your hands. Question number 1, define ideology. Question number 2, write 4 sentences about Islamic ideology. right four sources of Islamic ideology, right contents of ideology, right four significance of ideology. I would like to repeat the question again. You have the five questions for today. Number one, define ideology. Number two, write four sentences about Islamic ideology. Number three, write sources of Islamic ideology. Number four, write contents of ideology. And number five, write four significance of ideology. You can take the help from the page number five to the page number eight. You will write only the names. There is no need for the description because these are the short answer and question. Now,